back. There are many people who are organ transplant survivors worrying about how COVID-19 could affect their health. Joining us now is Dr. Oscar Serrano. He's live from the Hartford Healthcare Studios. He's a transplant surgeon with Hartford Hospital. Thank you for joining us, doctor.
Thank you for having me.
So tell us, are transplant patients at a higher risk for COVID-19?
So transplant patients present a very unique and interesting population. As many know, transplant patients have to be on lifelong immunosuppression, which means that their immune system, by definition, is suppressed. COVID-19, or what we understand about the disease, is a viral illness which also tends to have an immune response. That immune response tends to have deleterious effects on the body, especially the lungs. And so what we think happens in transplant patients is that they may acquire the disease, but their disease may not be as profound as in non-immunosuppressed patients. Now, so far, there's only been a handful of case reports from the world, primarily from China and Italy, and they have described a myriad of the disease spectrum, going from the mildest of flu-like symptoms all the way to catastrophic results.
Wow. What about living donors? Are they at a higher risk for COVID-19?
So living donors would not be necessarily at higher risk for getting the disease or having the effects of the disease. Living donors, by definition, are some of the healthiest people on the planet. We often call them the triathletes of patients because in order for us to remove an organ and transplant it into someone else, they have to be very healthy and be able to prove to us from a health perspective that they will lead normal lives with one less organ, for example, a kidney or a part of a liver. So no, by living donors don't necessarily pose any higher risk of getting the disease or having symptoms from the disease.
Okay, so I understand an emergency transplant recently occurred at Hartford Hospital. Tell us about that.
So at Hartford Hospital, like at many institutions around the country, we have been very selective in which patients we are transplanting. Transplant is always a high-stakes operation, a high-stakes medical procedure requiring long hospitalization as well as long after-surgery care. So with many of our transplant recipients, what we have been doing is going one by one and selecting out those that we feel may be at the highest risk of dying in the short-term future. And for those patients, those are the ones that we are moving forward in the process. For liver recipients, that would be patients that have a higher acuity in terms of their liver disease. For kidney recipients, those may be patients who are running out of access for hemodialysis. And as you mentioned, we performed a transplant last week in someone who was very sick and was probably going to die shortly. And so we transplanted them successfully, and they are currently in their recovery period.
Wow, that's just amazing. I've been in a kidney transplant and seen what you do, and it's totally amazing. And thank you so much for being with us. We appreciate your time today and your service to all your patients, too. Thank you, Dr. Serrano.
Thank you for having me.